It's really changed everything about our lives.
Crystal DelleChiaie is talking about preterm birth. Her daughter Natalia, now three, came more than 15 weeks early.
Very itty bitty.
Weighing just 1 pound, 10 ounces.
This is her first diaper.
Natalia is happy and sharp, but does have some mobility challenges.
The normal milestones that mothers look forward to, we achieve those much, much later, but we're learning.
Vermont has been working to reduce premature births. The state's health commissioner just accepted the Franklin Delano Roosevelt Award from the March of Dimes, recognizing that Vermont has the country's lowest preterm birth rate, 8.4% compared to the 12% national average.
Access is a lot of it. In many states where the premature rate is higher, women don't go to see doctors because they don't have insurance.
According to recent numbers from the March of Dimes, only six states have preterm birth rates below 10%, and three of them are in New England. Maine and New Hampshire are just about a percentage point behind Vermont.
This is great news for Vermont families. You know, we really run into a number of families that have experienced premature birth, and it is very traumatic almost in every case.
About half of Vermont's babies are born at the state's largest hospital, Fletcher Allen Healthcare in Burlington. Its neonatal intensive care unit had just a few tiny patients Thursday. Fletcher Allen credits Vermont's success in this area to good early prenatal care, to women cutting smoking and obesity, and to close communications between care providers, catching complications that can lead to prematurity.
The Institute of Medicine has estimated that it's a $25 billion per year problem, not only the immediate care of the preterm babies, but in the long-term disabilities that develop because of the prematurity.
Crystal DelleChiaie has become a volunteer fundraiser for prematurity research and education. While she's sure Natalia is perfect just the way she is, she hopes Vermont and its moms can keep striving for more full-term births.
It can happen to you, too.
In South Burlington, Jack Thurston, News Channel 5.